So the cool thing about performance enhancement, when you understand it, and variation, is that research has shown that many of these variables have the capacity to increase performance up to, not usually, but up to 21 times. So if you have a huge portfolio of enhancement categories that you can apply, and each one can increase performance separately 20%, 50%, 100%, whatever it is, combining a number of them is pretty profound. And most of them aren't going to do 21 times, which is 2100%. Most of them aren't going to do 10 times. They might not even do 5, but almost all of them will do 25, 50%, 100% separately. That's what drives me batty, that people insist on doing it the linear and the low yielding way when all this higher performing is so evident and available. So multivariable testing, I've been so blessed. And one of my two things, Deming, and then I work with the largest multivariable testing organization of its kind. This was pre-internet, so they may not be anymore, because they had the algorithms that were very sophisticated. Now it's free. It's free for most people, but they tested everything. They would test one way of saying things and selling against another. They would test how to position SKUs on an aisle in a grocery store. They would test follow up after a sale and how it would affect both retention, refunding, consumption of customer service or technical support. And when you see people that look at all those variables, you see how much impact you can have by doing things differently. It's quite profound. And if you don't try things like that safely, you're leaving opportunity and performance and impact and relational capital you could be building with new clients on the table. So you need to learn to do that.